In this video, I want to show you how to download daily precipitation and temperature data from NOAA. So to do that, and it's actually simple and free. So just open your browser and open a new tab. So here in Google, just search for Global Historical Climatological Network and click on Enter. So it will open this page called Global Historical Climatological Network. Then click on this link to open the main page. So this will open this page. The data is genuine and reliable. You can see this Global Historical Climatological Network, and it is a daily data. So here you can see the daily summaries here, and if you scroll down, you can see some menu here. You can see access, you can see time and location, you can see documentation here as well, and here is description. This is the description of the data, and if you are using this data for academic purpose, here you can see credits. This is the citation, how to cite this data. If you are using this data for research purpose, this is how to cite it here. Then here you can see keywords here, and also you can see the constraints, and you can see the lineage here as well. So to download this data, which is the purpose of this tutorial, we have to come back to this access menu. Come to access and come down here, you can see NCEI GIS map viewer. So let's just open it in a new tab. So it will open a page like this, and it takes sometimes few seconds to load. So wait for it to load. When it loads, it displays something like this. So this is what it display. Now if you look here, this data, this one, GHCN daily, is only available for US. And also if I uncheck this and check this daily normal, it's also available for US only. Likewise this one. However, if you check this global summary of the day, you can see it's available for the whole world. This one is available for the whole world. Now to download the daily data set, just click on this WMO. Click on WMO and you can see different stations. You can see thousands of stations here, all over the world. And if you are looking for specific location, you can come to this search for a location and search for any location of your choice. For example, let me say Nigeria. So I'll just click on Nigeria and it will take me to Nigeria and show me all the stations in Nigeria. You can see it here. And if you come here, you can see these two. This is map 2. Click on it and you can choose this identify tool to identify any location of your choice. If you click on any location, you can see the location here. You can see it is Enugu in Nigeria. And if you want to view details of this station, you can click on view station detail here. So that will open a new tab, and you can see the daily summary station details. You can see the name of the station is Enugu, and you can see the ID, and you can see the latitude and longitude, you can see the elevation, and of course you can also see the period of record. This is from 1973 to 2004. So any station you choose, you can view the details. And also, if you come here, this rectangle. For example, if I want to download data set from Ghana, Togo, Benin Republic, and Nigeria, so I can choose this rectangle, then come here and select some stations across these countries or region. So you can see here, it has selected different stations across the region I've selected. So if I'm interested in more than one station, for example, I want to download data for this station in Ghana, and I want to download this station in Togo, I want to download this station in Benin Republic, and I want to download this station alone in Nigeria. So after selecting these stations of my choice, just click on add to cart. So here in cart, you can see the daily summaries. You can see your selected cart options. You can see it here. So here, select the output format. If you want it as PDF or you want it as custom daily CSV. So in this case, I want it as CSV format. I'll check this. Then here, you can see select date range. So you can select the date range of your data set by clicking on here. And let's say I want it from, you can see you can download as far back as the year display here. So I want it from, let's say, 1980. From 1980, January 1st. Then I want to download up to 2023 or 2024. Let's say 2024 December. Or let's say 2024 July, for instance. July 31st. So once you have selected your range, just click on apply. So you can review the item in your cart. You can see the number of station you have selected here. So in this case, I've selected about 4 stations here. One from Ghana, one from Togo, one from Benin Republic, and one from Nigeria. So these are 4 stations I've selected. Then just click on continue. Here you can see custom option daily summaries here. So here under station details and data flag options, you can choose mark the station name, the geographical locations, include data flag, and here units, change it to metric. Then here you have to choose your data types for the output. So if you click on here, you can see precipitation here. Then if you want air temperature, average temperature, maximum temperature, and minimum temperature, just check out the data set you need. Click on continue. Then it's going to bring this page, which is review order. So you can review your order, the starting date, the end date, your output format, then the data types you have selected. So everything is here. Now you have to enter your email address. So let me enter my email address. After you have inputted your email, you can actually edit your order here. And once you are done, just click on submit order. So you can see your request was successfully submitted. An email with a link to the request data should be sent shortly. So now let's try to access our email. You can see 2 emails will be sent to your mail address. So this first one is just about your request, so to show you that it was submitted, and the second one to show you that it is complete. So click on the email that show complete, click on it, and you can see other completes, and here you can see the file download here. So click on download link, so you can see, so it's downloaded. So let me open the folder. So this is the data set I downloaded. I can now open it. So when I open it, you can see the station, you can see the name, you can see latitude, longitude, elevation, and of course you can see the date here. You can see precipitation, you can see the temperature, you can see the maximum minimum temperature here. So this is how to download daily precipitation and temperature data from NOAA. I hope this tutorial is helpful to someone. Please like this video and subscribe. Thank you for watching.